Okay, so now our study is limited to this second case. Huh? So when the charge is in motion at constant velocity, which will be producing electric and magnetic field both, that we are going to discuss now. Right? Okay. So you are already aware that Oersted was the name of the scientist. Oersted? Okay. So it was an accidental observation by Oersted. Accidental observation means what?
It is not intentional.
Right. So there was a wire. Okay. And it was connected with a battery. And when that wire with the resistor, when it is, you can say, current is passed through. Right? So accidentally that compass needle, that compass was brought near to it.
Yes,
sir. Accidentally.
Yeah.
Near to the current carrying wire. Accidentally, this compass needle was brought near to it and it was found that it is getting deflected. Okay. So compass needle is showing deflection only when there will be a magnetic field. Okay, so north pole or south pole is created, right, like that. So that was this. That's why it is called an accidental discovery.
Yes.
Okay, and then he tried to find out when he is moving towards this current carrying wire, so more deflection took place in this compass needle. When it is moving away, so opposite direction it has moved.
Okay.
Right. So this was an accidental discovery that a current carrying wire produces a magnetic field. Produces a magnetic field. Right. So now we are going to discuss about Lorentz force first. Lorentz force. So Lorentz force is what? It is a force, no doubt.
Yes.
And Lorentz is the name of the scientist. Right. So F is equal to, you can say that QE, the force due to that electric field, charge and electric field, plus QV, that is velocity, into B, and B is the magnetic field. Okay, so this B, B into B, so here vector product is playing major role, so it is a vector product. Okay, so that part we need to understand, vector
product.
So this Lorentz force is the sum of, you can say, electric force plus magnetic force. Electric force plus magnetic force.
B is what, sir?
Electric force and this is magnetic force.
Sir.
U is the charge, V is velocity at which the charge is moving. At which the charge is moving. So V is the velocity and B is the
magnetic
field. Okay? B is the magnetic field. Right? Okay. So this was the Lorentz force, you can say. In this, what it is there? Velocity and magnetic field. Okay, so there is an angle relationship. If it is there, so what will be writing B into B? So we will be writing V, magnitude of V and magnitude of V and sine theta.
Yes.
Okay, normal vector.
Yes.
So there is an angle relationship between V and B.
Yes.
There is an angle relationship. Okay. So this is called Lorentz force. So magnetic force depends on charge, velocity and magnetic field. So what you can write about magnetic force, depends on charge Q, velocity of the charge and magnetic field. Okay. You can also say that force on a positive charge will be opposite.
Yes.
Will be
opposite.
Opposite to the force on a negative charge, right?
Yes.
Yes or no? Okay. So in this, instead of Q, it will become minus Q.
Yes.
Okay. And that is minus Q means its direction will get reversed.
Yes.
So it will be opposite to that of charge. Okay. Vector product of V and B. It depends on vector product of V and B.
Yes.
It means there is an angle relationship between velocity and magnetic field. So angle relationship between velocity vector and magnetic field vector. Right?
Yes.
So what does it mean? Angle relationship means what? Suppose the velocity vector and magnetic field vector both are parallel to each other, then what will be the angle?
Zero.
Zero. Then in that case, the magnetic force will become
zero.
Okay. So that's why we are writing as angle relationship. Okay. So what we can write here, that if V and B are parallel,
yes sir,
or even anti-parallel, 180 degree, okay, or anti-parallel, that is 0 degree or 180 degree, okay,
yes sir.
So theta will be 0 degree, therefore magnetic force will be zero.
Yes.
Magnetic force will be zero. Magnetic force will be maximum at what angle?
90 degree.
Okay, good. So magnetic force will be maximum at theta is equal to 90 degree.
Yes.
Means when B is perpendicular
to B.
Yes or no?
Yes sir.
Right. When B is perpendicular to B, similarly if velocity vector itself is zero, okay, if velocity vector itself is zero, means B is not moving, in that case also magnetic force is zero. So that point also we will write, fourth one. Magnetic force will be zero if velocity vector will be equal to zero, that is charge is not moving. Charge is not moving. Okay. So only a moving charge, will experience the force. Right.
Thank you.
Okay. So what will be the unit of magnetic field? Unit of magnetic field is Tesla. Okay, it is Tesla. Unit of a magnetic field is Tesla. Right. It's a, you can say CBSE unit is also Gauss.
Gauss.
Okay. CBSE unit of magnetic field is Gauss. Right? Okay. So 1 Tesla is equal to 10 power of 4 Gauss. 1 Tesla is equal to 10 power of 4 Gauss. Right. So when there will be a force of 1 Newton, when 1 coulomb of charge moving at a velocity of 1 Newton, 1 meter per second. Okay. Then you can say that the magnetic field, it will be experiencing a force of 1 Newton. Okay. When the charge of 1 coulomb moving with a velocity of 1 meter per second experiences a force of 1 Newton, then we can say that the magnetic field is 1 Tesla. Okay. So if you are asked to define something, then define 1 Tesla. This type of question is also asked in examination. For 1 mark or 2 mark, it will be asked to you that define 1 Tesla. So if you want to define 1 Tesla, then from there what we will be finding? B is equal to, suppose B and B both are perpendicular to each other, maximum case, then magnetic field will be equal to F by QB. Okay, then it is 1 Newton divided by 1 coulomb into 1 meter per second. So this will be 1 Tesla. So what you will be writing in definition form?
When 1 coulomb of charge,
when 1 coulomb of charge moving at 1 meter per second velocity experiences a force of 1 Newton, then the magnetic field will be 1 Tesla. Okay, magnetic field generated will be 1 Tesla. Right? Okay. Good. Earth is also a magnet. Earth also creates a magnetic field. So its magnetic field value is 3.6 into 10 power minus 5 Tesla. Okay. So Earth magnetic field is equal to 3.6 into 10 power minus 5 Tesla. Do you remember drift velocity, what we have just read? in current electricity in previous chapter. Okay, drift velocity. So this is actually the drift velocity. Okay, and in that what Q was there? Q was the charge.
Yes, sir.
And that charge was number of electrons in volume, in unit volume. Okay, so in unit volume, so area and length, area of the conductor and length of the conductor. So this Q can be write as NeAl. Okay, if we are able to write in place of Q NeAl and then Bd into P, can we write like this? Okay, if we are writing like this, then F is equal to further. Can we write that
NeAbd is high?
Okay, NeA Bd into L into P. Can we write like this? Okay. And what is NeA Bd? Is the current. Okay. So is the current. So F is equal to I into L into P. Can we write like this? ILV. Okay. So here, as you know, that F is equal to I is not a vector quantity. I is not a vector quantity. So here I L will be written as, or you can say for a small length of element we can write as DL. This is the length vector into B vector. We need to put it in vector product. So length vector into B vector. So F is equal to I L B. Is also. So this will be there, the magnetic force due to current carrying conductor now. Current carrying conductor. Okay. So I has come here. So it is carrying current for a particular length of the conductor and magnetic field is generated here. So this is the magnetic force due to current carrying conductor. Right? So we can write as magnetic force due to current carrying conductor. Okay?
Yes.
Right. Just note it down. So here L, length of the conductor. Correct?
Yes, sir.
I is equal to current in the conductor. And B, magnetic field. Magnetic field. Thank you. Now, once the charge is entering in this magnetic field, right? Now, when the charge is entering in this magnetic field and when it is parallel to the magnetic field, suppose the charge is moving parallel to the magnetic field, in that case it will be experiencing zero force. In that case it will be experiencing zero force. Okay. So, when it is moving parallel or anti-parallel to the magnetic field, it is experiencing a zero force, right? Now, when it is moving perpendicular to the magnetic field, it will be experiencing a maximum force. Okay, so what will be there? Due to that maximum force, it will be getting deflected. So, that deflection will be taking place. And so suppose if that B is perpendicular to the magnetic field, okay, B is perpendicular to the magnetic field, it will experience a force, magnetic force, which is perpendicular to the velocity, which will be perpendicular to the velocity. A magnetic force will be created on this particle, which will be perpendicular to this velocity. Okay, so at each and every point, wherever it is, if this is the velocity V, then a magnetic force will be created in this way, which will be making the charge to move in circular motion. Which will be making the charge to move in circular motion. Okay, so now this charge will be moving at circular motion. Which is this force and V will be perpendicular, whereas V and B are perpendicular to each other. Okay, it means all F, B and B are perpendicular to each other. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes.
So V and this is F, B. This force,
V,
this force,
V, B and F, all three perpendicular.
Yes, all the three will be perpendicular to each other. So in that case, what will be there? The charge will have a circular motion. The charge will rotate in circular motion.
It will be like x axis, y axis, z axis.
Yes, x, y and z axis. Okay. So that charge will be having a circular motion. The charge Q entering the magnetic field in such a way that V is perpendicular to magnetic field. Okay, it will experience a magnetic force which will be perpendicular to velocity. Correct? So due to this force, the charge will have a circular motion.
Yes.
So in order to have a circular motion of the charge, we need to inject the charge in magnetic field perpendicular to it. If we are injecting the charge perpendicular to the magnetic field, it will be experiencing a force, and further the motion of the charge will be circular motion. It will be having a circular motion. Correct? Okay. So now what it is there? This force, so centripetal force will be acting here. Okay, so that centripetal force is acting here. Due to that centripetal force, it is having a circular motion. What is that centripetal force? What do you mean by centripetal force?
The force is towards the center of the area.
Towards the center.
Yes.
Okay, so towards the center. Okay. Right. So you can say that the force which next towards the center of the circle, correct?
Yes, sir.
Is called centripetal force. And value of centripetal force, Fc, is equal to mv square by r, and r is the radius of the circle. Okay, mv square by r. Now this centripetal force will be equal to the magnetic force.
Yes, sir.
Will be equal to the magnetic force. Okay. So you can say that Fc is equal to mv square by r will be equal to qvb.
Yes, sir.
Can we write the qvb? Okay. So from here we can find the radius of the circle. Whether we will be able to find the radius of the circle?
Yes.
Okay. So that radius of the circle r, or you can say radius of the circle r is equal to what?
Mv.
So this v and v can be cancelled with one v.
Yes.
Okay. So mv
by q
by qv. So this particular formula we should note it down. Okay, so r is equal to mv by qv. Okay, then what will be the angular velocity? Angular velocity omega. And angular velocity or linear velocity, what you know? Linear velocity, you are knowing the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. So v is equal to omega r. Omega r. Okay. So if you want to find angular velocity,
v
is equal to v by
r.
Okay. So that r we can put it here. So angular velocity we will be able to find out. So this one will be, you can say, v will be as it is, r is mv by qv, so into qv by mv. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this vv will get cancelled, so qv by m.
Yes.
So your omega is equal to qv by m. This will be angular velocity.
Okay.
Okay. So here I am noting it down, r is equal to, so r is equal to mv by qv, and omega angular velocity is equal to qv by m. Right?
Yes.
Okay. What will be the time period? Now angular velocity is there. Can we find the frequency?
Yes, one.
Omega is equal to what? Omega is equal to number of revolutions per second. Okay, that is theta by t. What it is?
Theta
by t. Okay, and theta is 2 pi?
Yes.
360 degree by t. Correct? Okay, so this is what angular displacement.
Okay.
Angular displacement twice pi by t. So you can say that the time period we can find twice pi by omega. Can we find time period? T is equal to twice pi by omega. So can we put value now? So if T is equal to time period, T is equal to twice pi by omega, is this one?
Qb
by m. So time period T is equal to twice pi m by
qb.
So with this we are able to find time period. Frequency nu is equal to 1 by T. Yes or no?
Yes.
Then it will be equal to
qb by 2 pi
m. Qb by twice pi m. So with this we are in a position to find out its frequency. Okay, time period, angular velocity, radius of the circle. Okay, right, very good, just put it down.